Hi, I'm Ben Meyer.
And I'm Rob Wright.
And this week we're going to talk a little bit about system requirements, specifically Crysis, which is probably the biggest PC release of the year, and takes some pretty advanced system requirements. Actually, here at Tom's Hardware, Tom's Games, we're building out a rig for Crysis specifically, and we're taking your advice out on the forums. So get on the forums and tell us what you think would be the optimal components for running Crysis, and we will put your feedback out there and definitely incorporate it into what we end up building out. This week also, EA came out and gave their minimum system requirements for Crysis, and it's interesting what they said. You know, it runs on XP or Vista. With the processors, though, it wants a minimum of 2.8 gigahertz or faster for XP, but 3.2 gigahertz or faster for Vista on a single core, and then 2.0 gigahertz for a Core 2 and 2.2 for Vista, respectively. And then again, for video cards, it recommends an NVIDIA GeForce 6800 GT or greater. And then on the ATI side, Radeon 9800 Pro or greater.
Wow.
So, Rob, you know, Crysis has always, the developers were saying they wanted it to make it so that you could go buy a machine a year or two in advance, or have a machine that was a year or two old. Do you think they succeeded based on these system requirements?
Well, I mean, as you pointed out, those are the minimum system requirements.
Yes.
Those aren't even, we haven't even touched the recommended requirements, which EA also announced this week. But I would say right now, looking at those specs and looking at what they've laid out for minimum system requirements, I don't think that they've really achieved that goal that they had to make it, you know, 1 to 2 years sort of backward compatible for older PCs. I got to be honest, we've played around with the multiplayer beta for Crysis a little bit. And like a lot of people, we've discovered that it's you're not going to get a lot of very good frame rates, even with current, you know, 2007 GPUs, CPUs, let alone, some, you know, stuff that's yet to come out before the end of the year or early 2008. So, again, that's the beta. And, you know, they always say about the beta, it's
a lot of times they clean up.
Yeah, they got to clean it up, and it's just a rough version of the game. So I have no doubt that they will do that, and they'll optimize it, you know, for the final version of the game, the full version when it comes out on November 16th. But I think, you know, from what we're seeing out there from our own readers and other publications out there as well, a lot of people are a little concerned about this.
It definitely puts this, and this goes back to kind of those discussions we were having about consoles last week, where, you know, I mentioned that consoles are more popular because it's cheaper. You get one console, you don't have to upgrade it as much, and, you know, you can play a wide range of games on it. You know, they might not have quite the graphical power of something like Crysis, but it's good enough. So do you think in general that this kind of trend of having these very kind of elite high-end games is a good strategy for PC gaming in general? I mean,
I do, because you're always going to need games
other than
like
for
that
helping to sell computer
parts.
Yeah,
exactly. No, but you're always going to need games like that that are going to push the limits. And, I mean, Crysis certainly does push the limit. And the thing that kind of, it doesn't irk me, but that I find odd is that for, you know, more than a year now, Crytek and EA have said, we want this to be able to be played by a wide range of PC gamers, whether you're using XP and DX9 or Vista and DX10. And I definitely applaud that, but if you can't really deliver on that, then it's a little misleading. And I think there are probably going to be a lot of people out there with Windows XP PCs out there that are going to be able to play this game. You're just not going to be able to crank up the settings, and you may have some pretty low frame rates. And I think that it's important to keep in mind that when they give out these requirements, they're not giving out these requirements so that you can crank all the settings up on high and on up to the max and play this flawlessly at, you know, 60 to 80 to 100 frames per second, because that's not going to happen. But it will be playable.
This is minimum. These are minimum requirements.
That's the other thing. I mean, these are minimum requirements. So you do have to wonder, you know, what it's going to take to run the game. Like, at the level that PC gamers want, because running it at 30 frames per second and having it dip down to 15 FPS occasionally, that's not going to cut it. It's not going to cut it for me, I'll tell you that.
So. Well, you know, let's talk generally again, because you just picked up the orange box today and been playing a little bit. All right, Rob's very excited, playing a little Team Fortress right before we got in the studio today. Yeah. And I checked out the minimum system requirements for the orange box, which it's just insane about how different it is from Crysis. And this is a new release. You know, obviously, they have different reasons for having different requirements, but it's, I mean, we're talking about their minimum system requirements being 1.7 P4 and DX8 card, you know, like, just much, much lower.
Yeah, I mean, and we should point out again that the design between a game like Team Fortress 2, which I love, and Crysis, I mean, it's worlds apart.
It's worlds apart.
However, you know, I think that, do you remember when we were talking about Crysis versus Halo 3 and what was going to be bigger? And what it ultimately came down is, hey, I may think that Crysis is going to be the better game, but it's not going to have the same type of audience because of what's going to be needed to play that game on a PC. And here's the other thing that I think is going to be lost in all this. People can play Team Fortress 2. And they can play it on an X-Beat machine, and they're not going to lose anything. But Crytek and EA have been pushing this idea that it's going to look amazing on DX10, and it's going to have unparalleled realism, which, I mean, we've seen it firsthand. It does. So you're going to want to play it on Windows Vista, and you're going to want to play it with DX10, because that's the way that it should be
that's
played.
That's what it was developed
yeah,
for.
Yeah, I mean, it's like movies coming out on HD and Blu-ray. It's like some movies you don't really care if they're being played on high def or not. It doesn't really matter.
Actually, there are some actors I'd rather not see.
Some movies you'd rather not see in high def. But, you know, certain movies like, let's say, Transformers, you're definitely going to want to watch that in high def. So, and Crysis is that type of high-def experience. Like, you're going to want to play it on DX10. You're going to want to play it on Vista. They're saying also that a lot of people are saying that you're going to want to play it on Vista 64. With that, I mean, that's even more money that you're going to have to shell out. So, I don't know. I mean, I know that we're definitely looking more, like, for our own Crysis rig, we're looking more at, you know, Vista and possibly the 64-bit version and DX10, because I think that that's what most people...
Yeah, it might just be one of those things where it's just not backwards, you know, it's not for older systems, period. Realistically, you know, it will work.
It will work, but it won't be...
It might not be worth it. We'll see.
But that said, what we're going to do here in the lab is we're going to try to run it on some older systems, XP systems, DX9, and try to do a comparison and just give people an idea of what it's going to look and play like on older systems, current systems, and then maybe some more advanced systems, and just to give people an idea of what it's going to be like. So.
Well, it will sure be interesting. Yeah. But that's all the time we have for this week. I'm Ben Meyer.
And I'm Rob Wright.
And we'll see you next time. This week also, EA came out with Crysis's minimum system requirements.
Yes.
And it's interesting.
Recommended.
And in lieu of that, I had to start over. Sorry. That's just came out weird.
In lieu of?
Yeah.
What, are we at a funeral?
Yeah. That's a joke.
You're rusty, dude. You're rusty.